afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's so nice to see such a large turnout this afternoon. And I'd like to start off by welcoming our guest speakers for this afternoon, Mr. Wadsworth.
Wordsworth?
Sorry, Wordsworth. Mr. John Coutts. And Percy Bysshe.
Shelley.
Oh, just a little one, medium dry. And Alfred Lord.
Tennyson.
Tennis ball.
Son.
Sorry, Alfred Lord, who is evidently Lord Tennis Ball's son. And to start off, I'm going to ask Mr. Wadsworth to recite his latest offering, a little pram entitled, I Wandered Lonely as a Crab. And it's all about ants.
I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden worker ants.
Thank you, Mr. Bradlaugh. Now, Mr. Bysshe.
Shelley.
Oh. Is going to read one of his latest psalms entitled Ode to a Crab.
Well, it's not about crabs, actually. It's called Ozymandias. It's not an ode. I met a traveller in an antique land who said six vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert, and on the pedestal these words appear, my name is Ozymandias, king of ants. Look on my feelers, termites, and despair. I am the biggest ant you'll ever see. The ants of old weren't half as bold and big and fierce as me.
Thank you, Mr. Amontillado. I'd like to ask one or two of you in the back not to soil the carpet. There is a restroom upstairs if you find the poems too exciting. Good afternoon. Next, Mr. Dennis Keat will recite his latest problem, Ode to a Glass of Sherry.
My heart aches, and a drowsy numbness pains my senses, as though an anteater I'd seen. A nasty, long-nosed brute with furry legs and sticky, darting tongue. I seem to feel its cruel jaws. Crunch, crunch, they go my leg. Snap, snap, my glorious throat. My hands in its way. They go my way. Swallow, swallow. It's true, don't you know? It's true. It happens, it happens.
Please. Ladies and gentlemen, I do apologize for that last. Well, I hesitate to call it a pram, but I had no idea. And talking of filth, I have asked you once about the carpet. Now, I do appreciate that last poem was very frightening, but please. Now, before we move on to tea and pram, which is, I would like to ask Arthur Lord Tennis Court to give us his latest little plum entitled The Charge of the Ant Brigade.
Half an inch. Half an inch! Whee! Whee! Whee!
My loyal subjects, we are here today on a matter of national import. My late husband and we are increasingly disturbed by recent developments in literary style which have taken place here in Germany, England. There seems to be an increasing tendency for the ant to become the dominant, was the deutsche theme of modern poetry here in Germany. We are not
amusiert,
entertained. From now on, ants is verboten. Instead, it's skylarks, daffodils, nightingales, light brigades, and
no. Have you got anything more exciting?
Well, how about a chase?
Was ist das schreckliche Gebong? Es schmeckt wie ein Scheißhaus! So weiter! Well, we must away now, or we shall be late for the races. God bless you, Alice!